Hey, it's Airsoft Mike and I'm here today to do yet another unboxing. Now, imagine a smaller version of this bad boy. Well, I've got one down here. So, down boy! What's going on here? Give it to me! So here it is, the Wee Bulldog PX4 compact pistol. Looks very nice. I really do like it. It's a gruesome little thing, isn't it? So I tell you what we do straight off. We'll just go into the accessories that you get straight out of the box. You get not only one, but two mags, one long, one short. The short one, I believe, takes up to around 20 rounds, and the long one, I believe, takes up to about 25. You also get one mag adapter or grip extension, and this goes on the bottom of the long one. Let me show you that right now. So let me just spin this around. I believe it goes that way. So let's have a look. Yep, that's sitting nice and flush, and that enables you to put it in your compact pistol. And everything looks nice and flush. Very nice, very flush. And for those of you with bigger hands, makes this pistol a lot easier and a lot more comfortable to hold. Right, so let's have a look and see what the smaller mag looks like when you put it in the gun. Nice. So it's nice and small and compact. The only thing being then is that your smaller finger is a bit loose, gone a bit freestyle. Look, see? Nothing to get a grip on, but not a problem for me. I actually still find it comfortable resting my little finger on the base of the mag. If anything, it gives me more stability, but hey, nothing beats having a longer mag with this little mag adapter at the bottom. So also included within this package are one pink backstrap, two pink backstraps, three pink backstraps, and then we have one black backstrap, two black backstraps, and a third black backstrap that comes installed on the gun. Doing that little count there reminded me of my Sesame Street days. Anyway, oh boy, I'm getting old. Right, so let's go through some of the basic features of this fantastic little sidearm. You got your safety lever, which is ambidextrous. You got your glow-in-the-dark sights, you got your takedown lever, you got your slide lock and release, you got your half-cock hammer, you got your threaded barrel, you have your changeable backstraps, you got your mag release, you got your short mag, and you've got your long mag. And you've got your rail. The pistol has a double-action trigger, so without cocking the hammer, I can go ahead, pull the trigger, and it will pull the hammer back and fire. And of course, it's single action. As mentioned before, the safety is ambidextrous and it also serves as a decocker. And that works like this. So for example, if I pull the hammer back, then I decide, oh, actually, I don't want to fire this gun. You can go ahead, pull the safety lever down and it decocks the gun. Another great little feature on this pistol, the glow-in-the-dark sights. Now, do they work? Well, I'm gonna switch off the studio lights and we're gonna test them out right now. So bear with, just get behind the camera. Let's see if I can find the switch on this studio light. Hang on. Okay, it's off. Ready? Let's have a look. Okay, so it's not the strongest that I have seen. I mean, it's a little weak on the back too, but the front one is stronger. So, as I mentioned before, this is like the smaller version of the full-size Beretta PX4 Storm. I really think it's just WeTech that gave this its nickname of the Bulldog. Damn boy. And this model does not have the real steel trades. It basically has the trades from Wii. It does have the 9 para stamp.
Groovy.
And as mentioned before, the serial number. So let me just show you the full size version of this. Very nice. This is the Beretta PX4 Storm. It's by HK3P. So obviously with those guys, they always put all your real steel trades all over the pistol. And as you can see there on this version, where you have the Beretta logo right there, on the WeTech model, it's just their Wii logo. So right here, I'm just doing a quick size comparison. You can see the height difference because both magazines have been lined up at the base. So you can see the height difference right there. And you can see the difference in the length of the barrel. Another significant difference between the two pistols are on the full size one, you have the rotating barrel. See that? When the slide goes back, the barrel rotates. So back to the Bulldog PX4 Compact. Another little quirky feature on this pistol, if I rack the slide back, you will see that on the end of the barrel, it is slightly flared. Can you see that? It's a bit bigger at the end here compared to the rest of the barrel. It has a nice rounded weight to it, and I'm not just saying that, it really does. When you hold this in your hand, you know you're holding this pistol. Don't let the size fool you. It packs a little weight. The serrations on the slide are here and here, making it easier to rack the gun from the back or from the front. Personally, I'll stick to the back. Okay, so let me quickly show you how to swap out these back straps. First thing you do is you drop the mag, locate and push this button right there, which is at the bottom of the grip. Push it in. And the back strap comes straight off. And if it's your thing, you can swap it out with one of the pink ones. Actually, let's have a quick look at it with the magazine in to give it that complete picture. Personally, not for me. So let's get back to black. Okay, so the hammer features a half cock function, so you can just pull it back half, leave it like that, and it will fire. The gun also features a takedown lever, and the way to do that is, first of all, as always, you drop the mag, then you get hold of this takedown lever, and from the front section, so okay, this is the front of the gun there, from the front section of it, you push it down and you pull it out. Comes out completely. You could just leave it hanging just on the edge there, but hey, just take it out. And then pull the slide back slightly and then forward, and the slide comes off, and there's your internals. Metal internals. And as I mentioned before, it is hop-up adjustable, and if you can just see it right there, see that wheel? That's where you adjust the hop-up. Okay, you know what's gonna happen now, don't you? Let's take it to the range. Okay, time for the shooting test. This is the Wii Bulldog PX4 Compact, or Subcompact if you like.
And as you can see, it's amongst a few other Beretta pistols. So yeah, meet the Beretta family. And so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make sure this PX4 Compact or the Bulldog works correctly. So I'm gonna start off with the short magazine and I'm gonna use some Nupro 2.0 green gas. I've already got a few BBs in there. Okay, just gonna test, make sure it works, take the safety off. Let's get closer to the camera. Right, here we go. Oh, very nice, very powerful. I'm liking it, so we know it works. Okay, so as always, I'm gonna do a rapid firing test. So I'll pull the trigger as fast as my finger can go. And then once all the rounds have been spent, I think there's about 10 or 11 in there, we'll see if the slide locks back and we'll see how the gun handles itself. Okay, so here we go, rapid firing test commences now. As always, I'm just gonna move this hand out of the way so you can see exactly what's going on. Here we go. Oh, I never get tired of that feeling of firing an airsoft pistol and seeing the slide lock back after the final round has been spent. So, how accurate is it? Well, let me drop the small mag. As mentioned before, it comes with two mags.
Here's the long mag with a little grip extension at the bottom there.
So I'll go ahead. It's already got some gas and BBs in there. And we're gonna test how accurate this pistol is.
Compact deserve a space on my wall of airsoft? Well, of course it does.